Okay.
Oh, you know, it's kind of like when I, a few weeks ago when I was sixth in the downhill, that meant as much to me as winning a slalom, you know. So doing my best here, if I give my best effort on that day and get to the bottom and feel like, ah, that was fun and felt good, then I'm going to try and be happy with that. If that's a gold medal, great. If it's a bronze, if it's 83rd place, I'm going to try and enjoy the experience anyway.
How are you?
And now Kristen Cooper will move into the start house. And she has a teammate at the bottom of the hill, Debbie Armstrong, in first place. The last English word she will hear will come from John Atkins, their friend, their confidant, the trainer of the U.S. ski team. And here she is, Kristen Cooper's run for the gold.
How about this, Frank? Debbie Armstrong in first place down at the bottom. Kristen Cooper. Oh, Kristen Cooper almost fell down. She sat right on the back of her skis. She's really ragged getting out of the start. She's going to have to really let them roll now.
We know her, Bob. We know that she will never lay back. She'll attack at any time. She really has ice water in those veins when she takes to a ski course.
Well, she's some competitor, and you got to take your hat off to her coming back from that injury. It's her race right now to win or lose. Her teammate sitting down in first place.
We'll compare her running time against that of Palin. Palin had the best time up at the top of the course, and this is Kristen Cooper. And Kristen Cooper, she lost quite a bit, but she had an edge to work with. Got a tenth of a second over Debbie Armstrong. Debbie Armstrong is waiting at the bottom of the hill. She's in first place at this point.
That mistake on the top cost her dearly. She's going to really have to go at the bottom now.
You know, Dr. Sedman is hanging on every turn. He put that left leg back together for her.
Okay.
Here she comes.
She's skiing a lot better now. She's got herself together a little bit better down now. Finish line.
You see the time that she must beat come up on the left. That is, she has to beat that time to take the lead. Kristen Cooper going for the gold. The American steering at the finish line. Here comes Kristen Cooper.
Second
place. We've got a 1-2 thus far. Oh, wow. Debbie Armstrong is in first place. Kristen Cooper is in second place.
Frank, Kristen Cooper lost the gold medal right on the top, but I'll tell you, she won the silver on the bottom. She really came back on the bottom part of the course. She did a great job down below.
A smile on her face right now. The Americans 1-2, and they're looking good. They're looking good as gold and silver.
Boy, Frank, this is a great day.
And already the congratulations are starting to spread. There is Michelle Rudigoz, the coach of the women's team, hugging his girls. And of course, still races to come. Tamara McKinney was in eighth place after the first race. She has a lot of time to make up. Tamara McKinney was 24-1 and 24 hundredths of a second out of first place. Let's take a look at that costly mistake Kristen made up at the top of the course.
Frank, in ski racing, mistakes happen very quickly, and usually you don't get to recover. Watch here now as she comes down and sits right on the back of her ski, as we can see right here. Most ski racers would have fallen down. She caught herself with her hand. She lost a lot of time, but she did pop right back up. And on a flat hill like this, you really can't afford mistakes like that. She lost a really
So right now, the United States is 1-2, and here's Dr. Stedman. You think doctors don't shed a tear now and then? There's one in that eye. He's put so many athletes back together again. Phil Mayer, Cindy Nelson, Kristen Cooper, and so many others.
And knowing as well as I do, he bleeds right with them, too.
What a rewarding moment. We'll be back to watch Tamara McKinney in a moment. Gold and silver, Debbie Armstrong and Kristen Cooper, teammates who started this year dry land training last summer. They're together now at the finish line here in Yaharina. Tamara McKinney up at the top. Tamara McKinney, she was in eighth place after the first run. She really knows what she has to do, Bob. Right now, Armstrong is sitting in first place. Cooper is in second place. Corinne Helen is in third place. And Tamara McKinney has to pick up 47 hundredths of a second to get in there for a medal. It's almost an impossible task, but if anyone will give it a go, this little 21-year-old United States skier will.
She's a great talent, Frank, and if she unforks a run like she's capable of, she's got it in her, she could do it. She can make up half a second over Palin. She can get up in there and get a medal. She was a little ragged on that first one. She was very weak on the top part of the course, so she's got to loosen up a little bit and really let him go.
The United States first overall World Cup champion a year ago. She won the World Cup Giant Slalom Championship, and here she is trying to get back in it from eighth place after the first round. That's her running time on the right. Palin's time is still the best. There it is at the left. That was her time on the top. Palin, she's sitting in third place.
Oh, she's got a good midway time.
She's got a good shot now.
Now she's got to make up a lot of time, though, down here at the bottom. She had a good time on the top part of the course, so she's seeing a lot better than she was in the first one.
Tamara McKinney now working down through the lower gates.
She'll move up a lot, Frank. Whether she can move up in the medal position, we'll have to see.
Debbie Armstrong is the leader. Kristen Cooper is second.
Oh, look at her skiing. She's skiing very well down here now. She's really using her knees and ankles. They're getting off. She almost went over a tip.
That time on the left is the one to beat to take the lead, but she's looking for a bronze. She hammers across the finish line to the end fourth place, and she just does miss.
But I'll tell you, she had a great run in that second run, moving up into fourth place. How about that, Frank?
Right
first,
now.
Second, and fourth.
Not bad, Coach. Not bad at all. Never been a day like this in American alpine skiing. I first covered in Europe in the early 70s. I remember hearing an announcer say when one of our youngsters did poorly at the Hahnenkamm, too bad, USA. That's not the story here today. And what a moment at the finish line. Tamara McKinney is there. Debbie is there. And, of course, Kristen Cooper. Great effort by Tamara McKinney just to come in fourth after being in eighth place following the first run. But there is a stunned gold medalist, Debbie Armstrong. Debbie and Christine. No one could be happier about it than my colleague, Bobby Addy. He coached his team in tougher years.
Guys, great going.
Great day. Gosh, it feels great.
Tell me, what did it feel like up there? You know, you were came in this thing with a fifth, and, you know, you really rolled them. In that first run, looking at you in the starting gate, you were just really charged up.
Oh, I just felt so good. I felt so high. I was having so much fun. I pre-skied on the hill yesterday, and I knew that it was a good hill for me. And if I thought if I just go up there and have the time of my life, which I did. And if
also
I
have a gold medal.
I knew that if I did that, then something else would hopefully come along with it.
Did you ever in your wildest dreams think you were going to be standing here right now with an Olympic gold medal?
Maybe my wildest dreams.
But it was a wild dream, right?
It was a wild dream. Yeah, oh man, this morning I thought, I've been feeling good on my skis, and I knew if I could just go up there and keep my head on right, that I could ski well. And because this is the Olympics and anything can happen, and it did.
When Kristen finished and you saw that you'd won the gold and that she hadn't beaten you, I'm sure you didn't know that she'd had a little problem up above. Your first words were, oh my God, what'd you think of then?
I couldn't believe it. I just, oh man. I knew Coop was going to be strong. She's such a tough fighter.
Well, how about your teammate over here, Coop?
Yes.
You made that little mistake on the top, but I want to tell you, you have nothing to apologize for. Silver medal and what you've come back with, all the injuries and everything else this year. A lot of us are really proud of yourself. How about that?
All right, thanks a lot. Now I feel good about it for sure.
How did you feel about that mistake at the top? You knew you'd made a big mistake and lost some time.
Yeah, it made me a little late. It really wasn't anything that I couldn't make up. But I think I probably, again, had a little more trouble on the bottom. I was trying to make up time from that mistake, and I went a little straight in places where the course was quite turny.
So, you know, you had 2 hours between runs, a lot of time to think. What was going through your mind?
As little as possible. I thought about my boyfriend and my family.
Well, that's a nice thing to think about. A nice relaxed day here on the mountain.
That's right. Well, that's what you need to do, you know, is sort of find your center and keep things as calm as possible. And it worked.
Hey, Tamara. Hey, great going to you. I know you weren't too happy with that first run, but on that second one, you really rolled them coming down here.
Yeah, I did. I was really happy with the second run. A little great day for these two guys. It would have been nice to be 1-2-3, but 1-2-4 isn't bad.
1-2-4 isn't bad. It's sensational. You guys are great. I'll tell you, it was a great day for you. Congratulations. Back to you, Frank.
Debbie Armstrong the gold, Kristen Cooper the silver, and they symbolize the culmination of years of effort by so many to bring the United States ski team up to par with the Europeans who have dominated the sport for so many years. It'll be a long, long time before we'll have to listen to an announcer say, too bad, USA. Today in Sarajevo, the U.S. is number one and number two.